Hello students, in the previous session what we discussed? We discussed the taxonomic hierarchy and binomial nomenclature. What is taxonomic hierarchy? It is the arrangement of the various taxonomic units in descending or ascending order on the basis of their taxonomic rank or level. The various taxonomic units are the kingdom, phylum or division, class, order, family, genus, species. So highest taxonomic rank among these seven categories is the kingdom, and lowest unit of the taxonomy is the species. Who is the father of taxonomy? Yes, father of taxonomy is Carlos Linnaeus. What is binomial nomenclature? Binomial nomenclature, you see, these are the 2.5. You get in 2.5 short note. You have to answer within the 4 to 5 sentences. Okay, 2.5 marks, 2.5 marks. And rest I have written here for 1 mark questions. Who is the father of taxonomy? Carlos Linnaeus. Okay, what is binomial nomenclature? We are discussing is the biological system of naming of the biological system of giving name, scientific name to a properly identified species using two words. Binomial, two word naming, the two words, that is the first word indicates that it defines the genus or generic name. The second word defines the species name or specific epithet. Epithet means name, and they should be written separately when printed italic. Rules are, what are the rules? They should be reprinted in italic. The two words should have a gap within them, in between them, and the genus starts with a capital letter, species starts with a small letter. If handwritten, they should be underlined separately. Is it? Yes. Now, who introduced the binomial nomenclature? Yes, again Carlos Linnaeus. Carlos Linnaeus. A trinomen consists of the three words. What are they? Genus, species, name of genus, species, and subspecies. It depends upon the geographical location where they are found. Okay, some scientific names. Tell the scientific name of tiger. What is the scientific name of tiger? Yes, Panthera tigris. While writing, how you have to write? You have to underline. You have to underline the genus and species. Lion, Panthera, Panthera, Leo. Panthera is the genus, Leo is the species. The tiger and lion belongs to the same genus. Rohu, you are eating rohu. Labio rohita. What is the scientific name of rice? Yes, Oryza sativa. You have to underline Oryza sativa. What is the scientific name of, yes, human being? Homo sapiens. Okay, like this you have to practice a lot of scientific names. Okay, in this session we are going to discuss the basis of classification of the animals or animal kingdom. In spite of huge diversity, diversity means variation or differences in structure, like morphological and anatomical habit, habitat, different physiological functions, digestion, respiration, excretion, circulation of various animals, there are some fundamental basic features common in individuals, in individual organisms, in relation to the arrangement of cell, that is level of organization, body plan, body symmetry, their coelom, germ layer. Some features they are common. Okay, so what? In spite of huge diversity, huge diversity, that is variation, this diversity in structure. Structure means it may be morphology or anatomy. See, or anatomy, external structure or internal structure. Anatomy, habit, habitat, different physiological functions, different physiological functions of various animals . There are some basic fundamental or there are some fundamental or basic features common among the various individual organisms, common in various individual organisms. Here we are talking about animals, organisms or animals in relation to the arrangement of cells, arrangement of cells, that is level of organization, how cells are arranged, that makes the level of organization. Body plan, body symmetry. What is the body plan? Body symmetry, the coelom, the germ layer, coelom, the body cavity, coelom, germ layer, the segmentation also known as metamerism. The notochord. Okay, there are some features which are in common to all the different organisms. On this basis, on the basis of these features, the classification of animal kingdom is drawn. Any even classification of living organisms, they are based on some specific features. Here the classification of animals, that means animal kingdom, is based on some common features. So what is basis? What you can say basis means? Basis means certain certain characteristic features based on which the classification of animals is drawn. Basis means certain characteristic features based on which the classification of animals or classification of living organisms is drawn. So these are the basic features. We will discuss one after another. Levels of organization. It is the arrangement of the cells. Animal starts with the cellular level of organization. Animal start with the cellular level of organization. Okay, then it leads to tissue level. Then organ level of organization. Then the organ system level. Organ system level of organization. The cellular level of organization, where the cells are arranged, cells are arranged in loose aggregates. Loosely the cells are only aggregated. They place together and there is the division of labor among the different type of cells. Division of labor, you see, Shrama Vibhajana. Division of labor is drawn among. Division of labor is drawn among. Among the different type of, different kind of cells. The example is porifera, sponges, phylum, phylum porifera. Which animals are in cellular level of organization? Yes, phylum, the animals of phylum porifera, commonly known as sponges. The poriferans, porifera, animals of porifera, poriferans, they are commonly called sponges. Then as we know, there are some there are many unicellular organisms. There are some unicellular organisms which are animal like, which are called protozoa. Protozoa, the animal like protista, they are unicellular. Then what is their level? Level of the protozoans, unicellular protists, it is the protoplasmic level, because the body means single cell. All the life functions are carried out within that single cell. All the life functions like the respiration, digestion, excretion, the distribution of the food, assimilation, everything is carried out within that single cell. Body means that cell. So that is, that comes, that occurs, all vital activities carried out inside the protoplasm. So level of protozoans, the primitive animals which are not coming under the animal kingdom, that is protoplasmic level. So at least you should have the knowledge above the cellular level. Above the cellular level, which level of living organism? The protoplasmic level. I have given star, no space over here. Protoplasmic level. Okay, protoplasmic level of organization. Organization here. The examples are unicellular organisms. Example are unicellular organisms. But when we think about the animals, animals means animal like unicellular, animal like protista are the protozoans. Okay, are the protozoans. Animal like organisms which are found in the kingdom protista, they are known as protozoans. Protozoans means protozoans or protozoa. They are the protista or the protozoa. Proto means primitive. Primitive. Zoa means animals. Okay, but concentrate from the cellular level, the organisms, the from of the animal kingdom, this belongs to animals, animalia kingdom, animals. Okay, from cellular level. Then comes the tissue. After cellular level, tissue level, the group of cells, the performing the similar function, the group of cell performing the similar function makes the tissue. Where in tissue level of organization, that means tissue level, this is cellular level of organization. Okay, this is tissue level of organization. Organ level of organization, organ system level of organization, we will discuss. Where the group of cells of similar structure perform similar function, cells of a similar structure and perform perform similar function, perform similar function function they make a specific tissue, make the tissue means group of cell makes the tissue. Group of cell, which group of cell which are similar in structure and perform the similar function, they make the tissue. And which in which the division of labor, the division of labor among the, here division of labor, division of labor is done among the different tissues. Division of labor is done among the tissues. Among the tissues. And here the example are the phylum animals of phylum Coelenterata and phylum Ctenophora. Phylum Coelenterata. Coelenterates. Coelenterata or Coelenterates and the Ctenophora. Here tissue is formed in cellular level of organization. In there the porifera makes the cellular level. Tissue is not formed. Tissue is not formed. Here tissue is formed. Different various tissues are formed. But organs are not formed. Organs are not formed. Are not formed. Okay. Now, organ level of organization. Organ level of organization. Here, the animals where the organ, the tissues, they form the group of tissue, they form the organ. Here the various tissue, different tissue make the organ. In the organism where the different tissues make the organ, where the organ system, organ is developed in which animals, we will tell that those animals belong to organ level of organization. So example is here the platyhelminthes. Here platyhelminthes, which are commonly known as the flatworms. Flatworms. Okay, generally told in Odia, Chapter Krumi. Flatworms, platyhelminthes. Here the organs are developed. So then organ system level comes. In organ system level, various organs, they are grouped, they are organized to make the specific organ system or the functional system which perform the specific life processes. There are various life processes. Yes, digestion, respiration, excretion, circulation. So various organs, they make the organ system, the different organ system, like the digestive system does the digestion, respiratory system does the respiration, circulatory system does the circulation of body fluid, and the excretory system perform the excretion. Okay, here what happens, the organs here, the organism, the organ system level, where organs are grouped or arranged, organ system level of organization, grouped into an organ system okay, that is various organ system, as I told. Okay, and these are seen among the animals. Ask helminthes onwards, upward, where these are seen. Ask helminthes annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, then the echinodermata, and chordata. From porifera to echinodermata, these are invertebrates or non-chordata. They do not have notochord. They do not contain notochord. They do not have vertebral column. Okay, non-chordata, chordata. We will study invertebrates. So these animals coming under the organ system level of organization, where the different organ system, like the digestive system, respiratory system. Here examples of organ system are, we can give the digestive system, respiratory system, etc., are developed, which perform these systems perform the various life functions. Three types of body plan. How many? There are three types of body plan. They are the cell aggregated plan, then blind sac plan, and tube within a tube plan. Cell aggregated plan, then the blind sac plan, and the third one is tube within tube plan. Cell aggregated plan, where number of cells, they are aggregated to form a body, to form an individual organism where no tissue which lacks the tissue or organs and a very few the division of labor is done among the cells. The cell aggregated plan is seen in the sponges. In sponges, okay, and this is due to the aggregation of aggregated cells giving rise the organism lacking tissues and organs and a very few a few division of labor among the cells. Okay, then the blind sack plan. In blind sack plan, what is there? The tissues are formed. The cells are grouped into tissues. Tissues are organized in such a way forming a body cavity. They are having a cavity and that is act as surface the digestive tract and only one opening to this body to the body or body cavity that is mouth which surfaces mouth as well as anus for ingestion and egestion. Here what happens, the example of the cnidarian cnidarians tenophores and platyhelminthes okay. Here the cells grouped into tissues. Even in platyhelminthes, even the tissues are organized. Tissues grouped into organs in case of platyhelminthes. Tissues grouped into organs in platyhelminthes. Here the body is having a single cavity. Body is having a single cavity consists of a single cavity or body cavity which serves as digestive tract where inside which cavity the digestion occurs. Digestion, the breakdown of large molecules. Digestive tract, that is the digestive tract with a single opening with a single opening. The single opening act as mouth as well as anus. The single opening this act as the mouth as well as anus that performing ingestion. Mouth ingestion, anus ingestion, performing what? Mouth ingestion, intake of food, ingestion, and anus ingestion respectively. You can say body is having a single opening which opens into the digestive tract, or the single body cavity. The body is having a cavity. That cavity works as, that performs, that serves as the digestive cavity. The digestive cavity which opens to outside through single opening. That opening acts as, it acts as, the single opening acts as, what I'm telling, single opening acts as mouth as well as anus, performing the ingestion and egestion. Egestion, removal of waste material. Ingestion, intake of food respectively. Okay, so what is sac means? A bag like structure, bag. Suppose you think about, this is a pouch having the single opening. You see in the, this is the body. Okay, body has some thickness, body wall is having thickness, this is the cavity and having the single opening, that is called mouth. As it is seen in the hydra, seen in hydra, example hydra, platyhelminthes. Hydra is a cylindrata. Now tube within a tube plant, this is exhibited by the higher invertebrates and all vertebrates, where the digestive tract is complete. Here the digestive tract is present in platyhelminthes but incomplete. Anus is not present. Okay, that's why they are also coming under the blind sac. Blind sac, where only one opening there. There is no exit. Only entry and exit through single opening. That is called blind sac. Sac means bag or the pouch. Okay, like that. So now, tube within tube plant, in this blind sac plant, cell aggregated plant, and tube within a tube plant. Here, the digestive tract is complete. Digestive tract is complete. Okay. Complete, consisting of two openings, that is mouth and anus. Okay, here the digestive tract is present within the another tract, is a tube like structure. The digestive tract makes one internal tube, a tube with two openings, mouth and anus, which is present within another tube. The outer tube makes the body. The outer tube, this is a tube found within another tube which makes the body wall, which makes the body wall. Okay, the body wall makes the like this. If this is the one tube within which another tube two tubes, the outer tube makes the body wall, this makes the body wall, and this makes the digestive tract. The digestive tract has two opening, one makes the mouth, another makes the anus. It is seen in higher invertebrates, that is which are coming under the organ system level of organization, that is starting from Aschelminthes or Nematoda and all vertebrates. Higher invertebrates starting from Aschelminthes to Echinodermata, and all digestive tract. Okay, Aschelminthes to Echinodermata, Aschelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. And all vertebrates or all chordates, Okay, now these are again are of two types. The tube within tube plant, the animals having tube within tube, they are of two kinds. One is protostomic. There are two type, protostomic and deuterostomic. Protostomic and deuterostomic. What is the difference? Proto means first. Stoma means, the stomach means, came from stoma means mouth. In which animals the mouth is formed first in the embryo? Yes, the prenatal stage before birth, the stage before birth is the embryo, bhruna in Odia. So in the embryonic stage, when the mouth is formed first, then these animals are called protostomic. These animals are called protostomes, and the pattern is the tube within tube plant is protostomic plant, and protostomic and deuterostomic when the anus is formed first. Deutero means second. Stomic word came from stoma, that means mouth. In protostomes, mouth in animals, where mouth of digestive tract, I am writing digestive tract, develops first and anus develops later. Develops develops later, afterward. In embryo, then the plan is called protostomic plan. Okay, then this tube within tube plan is called protostomic plan, and the animals called protostomes. Okay, here mouth of digestive tract develops first, anus develops later, and these animals are called protostomes. Example, which are the example? Tube within tube plan, that means ask helminthes. They have developed the digestive tract, and then annelida. The arthropoda. Animals are ask helminthes, annelida, arthropoda, and mollusca. Okay. Deuterostomic, the tube within tube plant is deuterostomic when the anus is formed first, mouth is formed later, mouth develops later, so anus develops first, where anus develops first, anus of the digestive tract, anus of the digestive tract develops first, and mouth develops later. Then this plan is called deuterostomic plan, and the animals called deuterostomes. Okay, and the example are the echinodermata and all chordates. Echinodermata, animal of echinodermata phylum, and the chordata. Animals are chordata, all chordates. Okay, here what happens, do you know one structure, blastopore is there, you see. If this is the egg, this is the sperm, then it produces, what it produces? The zygote. Okay, zygote that divides and becomes morula. What it is called? Morula. Then that solid ball like structure, number of cells are formed here, 16 to 32 cells are present. This is single cell. In this case, the embryo is unicellular embryo. Zygote is an unicellular. Zygote is the unicellular embryo. Then that multicellular stage of the embryo is called morula, where all the cells are present making a solid ball, okay, no cavity within it. Then it forms, arranged into the hollow ball like structure. Okay, hollow ball cavity is there. This is called blastula. This is called blastula. Blastula that develops a pore in it. All the cells are they pushed outside, and at the center the cavity is formed. Then this ball, hollow ball like structure, that develops into another structure like this, having a pore in it. That becomes double layer. When the tube within tube structure is going to be formed, when the organism's body is going to be formed tube within tube, okay, then a pore is formed. The blastula, you see, the blastula is here. Suppose one side that is pushed inward. Here, the pushed inward in the hollow ball. Just imagine a ball is there. And air is leaked. You can able to push it from one side. So a cup within cup, a tube within tube. Okay, is formed, and this pore is called, now this pore is called blastopore. So a opening which is formed first in the embryo is called blastopore, but this stage is called gastrula. It is gastrula. So if the blastopore becomes mouth, then the animals are protozoans. If the blastopore becomes anus, then animals are grouped into deuterostomes. Animals are called deuterostomes. What condition? Yes, remember this. If the blastopore is the single opening of the gastrula stage of the embryo, the first embryo stage, unicellular embryonic stage, is the zygote. When egg is fertilized by a sperm, the fertilized egg is called zygote. Zygote is a unicellular embryo. Then it divides and grow into the multicellular solid, the ball like structure called morula. Then the embryo becomes a hollow ball like structure having a fluid filled cavity. Here the fluid is there, fluid filled cavity called blastula. Then blastula develops into the gastrula. In gastrula, the body of the embryo becomes double layer. It is going to form tube within tube. Okay, so out of the body wall and inner layer is going to digestive tract. First of all, a pore is formed in this stage, called blastopore. Do not get confused, gastrula, but pore is called blastopore. When the blastopore becomes mouth, then what becomes anus? Another pore is formed, another opening is developed, that opening becomes anus. Here blastopore becomes anus. That means the first opening is formed in the gastrula stage, that become in the embryo. Gastrula is embryo, blastula is different stages of the embryo. embryo, that is the stage before birth, prenatal. Natal means birth. Prenatal, before birth. We have used this word prenatal in the living characteristic. The before the prenatal stage, that stage is called embryo. In the embryo, different stages are there. Stages are there. In the gastrula stage, there is an opening called blastopore. If the blastopore becomes anus, they belong to the deuterostomes. The animals are called deuterostomes. Okay. Symmetry. It is the arrangement of the similar organs or body parts in relation to a plane or axis. What I am saying? Symmetry is the arrangement of similar organs and the parts of the body into two groups in relation to a plane or a axis. Suppose we can be divided into two equal halves, two symmetrical halves, two identical halves. In each half, one eye, one ear, even the half of the mouth, half of the nose. Nose is also having the two parts, that is left and right part. So one hand, one leg, like this. Irrespective, of course, many internal organs are also there, but it is mostly irrespective of the internal organs. But even you think the two lungs, two kidneys, heart is having four chambers, so it can be also divided into. So what are the types of symmetry? That are the, what is symmetry first? Symmetry is the arrangement of similar organs, or parts of the body in relation to a plane or axis, to a plane or axis is called the symmetry. So is called symmetry, and animals exhibit animals exhibit or show the following type. So the following type of symmetry, mainly two types, radial and bilateral. And those who are not showing any symmetry, they are asymmetric. Animals are asymmetric, bilateral symmetric or radial symmetric animals. But the animals exhibit the following type of symmetry. That are radial symmetry, bilateral symmetry, and the asymmetric. Radial symmetry. When a that particular plane or axis, okay, when a relation to a particular specific particular when a particular plane or axis can divide the body of the animal into two identical or symmetrical halves, then it is called radial symmetry. When what happens when any plane, not a specific, when any plane, I will show you, when any plane can divide the body of an animal, into two identical or symmetrical halves, then this type of symmetry is called radial symmetry. Then the type, then it is called radial symmetry seen in the coelenterates, ctenophores, and the echinoderms. Okay, so even the radial symmetry is of different kind. Just see it. It is coelenterata, that is in Hydra. Hydra, I can show you here. Hydra already you have drawn. It can be cut into two halves in any plane. You take the cross section, okay, like this, the circular the cross section is coming. You can cut in this way, you can cut in this way. This is any plane can cut the body of the organism into two equal halves. This is in case of, this is radial, pure radial, completely radial symmetry. This is in Hydra. Think about the another organism, the coelenterate, of the coelenterata, the sea anemone. So how it can be? You see, somewhat oval shaped like this. Can you cut into any plane? That is vertical plane. Remember, here the vertical plane, divide can the when any plane can divide the body, any plane, any vertical plane. Here the plane is any vertical plane, vertical plane. Okay, so here it can be cut into two equal halves, either in this way, in this plane, or in this plane, in this plane or this plane. So here it is biradial. Radial become biradial. More than one, then radial. If the body can be divided into two equal halves, at least more than one plane, then it is radial. So here biradial. And here I told you echinoderms. So echinodermata is star piece. Star piece. In star piece, how many planes are there? Yes, pentaradial, 5. This is one plane. This is one plane. One plane. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5 planes are there. So pentaradial symmetry. And even tenophores, only biradial symmetry is seen. Biradial symmetry. Radial again different types. Okay, then in the bulbous and algae, green algae, volvox is there, spherical in nature, spherical volvox. And green algae alga is singular. Green algae like this, hair like structures are here. Anyhow, this is spherical in nature, spherical. So what would be the plane? And not only vertical, what is this here? Not only vertical, any plane. So this is spherical symmetry. The radial symmetry is a spherical type. Spherical radial symmetry or spherical symmetry. Okay, in bulbous, it is showing the spherical symmetry in the bulbous. Okay, these are the different type of, and the animals are called radially symmetric animals. Animals are called in bilateral symmetry. Animals called radially symmetric. Radially symmetric animals. Okay, draw all this. Bilateral symmetry, this is over. Okay, radial symmetry we discussed. The bilateral symmetry, when a body when a body is divided into two equal halves by only one plane, that is bilateral symmetry. Or we can say when a plane passing through the central axis central axis of the body can divide when a plane passing through the central through the central axis of the body can divide into two identical left and right halves, two identical left and right halves. Then that symmetry is called bilateral symmetry. When only one plane, the body, in other word, you can write down, when the body, in simpler language, when a body can be divided into two identical left and right, identical left and right halves by only one plane, however you can write, then the symmetry is called bilateral symmetry, and the animals are called bilateral symmetric animals. Animals called, or this way or this way you can write down, animals called bilaterally symmetric animals. Example you can go with, starting from platyhelminthes to the chordates. Platyhelminthes to chordates. Okay, here I am giving one example. It can be divided into two equal halves, and the plane when passes through that lengthwise. You can see, suppose this is a fish. We are talking about the, what we are talking about the bilateral symmetry. Okay, bilateral symmetry only. Suppose this is the fish. All chordates I told. Okay, lengthwise it can be cut into two equal halves. Okay, then, or we also just imagine, as in the beginning I told, we can be divided into two equal symmetrical identical halves. In each half, the similar organs or the body parts will be formed. So single plane can divide into two equal halves is called the bilateral symmetry, that is giving rise left and right. When we tell the this is right side of the body, left side of the body, left and right two equal or identical or symmetrical halves. So platyhelminthes two chordates. Example, again you can take fishes are the chordates. Fishes, the birds, all along with the human beings. Okay, then the asymmetry. When the body cannot be divided, you see, now asymmetric. Asymmetric. When the body cannot be divided into two identical halves by any plane is called asymmetry. When the body cannot be divided into two symmetrical halves by any plane passing through the center is called asymmetry. The animals showing asymmetry are called asymmetric animals. Animals showing asymmetry are called asymmetric animals. Actually, the symmetry may lead up two types: radial symmetry and bilateral symmetry. Another is asymmetry. It is for mainly the animals, because there is no symmetry. This is not the type of the symmetry. This is no symmetry. So when there is no symmetry, animals are called asymmetric animals. When you will be asked what are the types of animals on the basis of symmetry, then you will write down the animals are of three types: radial symmetric, bilaterally symmetric, and asymmetric animals. When you are being asked what are the types of symmetry, then you will write down the symmetry are of two types: either radial symmetry, when any plane cut into two equal halves, at least more than one plane. Any plane means, example, most of the sponges and snail. Okay, snail. Why snail? Snail, you know, you see in the drains, in the water logs, they are found. The animal present in this. So this is the snail. Animals present in this. How you can divide into two equal halves? No. So snails and sponges. You see many sponges. Some sponges I am showing you over here. Suppose many colonies, they are found . So this is how the cycon. Most of the sponges cannot be divided into two equal halves. Even the snail, which belongs to mollusca. Okay, cycon belongs to sponges or porifera.